So I love that we picked this topic, our viewers picked this topic. Clearing up diet myths, there are so many out there. Yep. We've got a few of them. We'll get through as many as we can. So true or false, the timing of your food has nothing to do with weight loss.
So the timing of your food has nothing to do with weight loss. True or false, it is?
False.
Timing of your food is really important, actually. False, right? So City Line viewers have heard me saying, we talked about it before, that what you eat from 3 p.m. on makes it or breaks it for weight loss. And that's not that you have to eat nothing, but now I have research to support this. So the reason that this clock is at 4:12 is the latest research shows that most people blow their diet from 4:12 and on. Mm. And it's not that your metabolism suffers as the day goes on. It's that you're tired, you're moody, you're cranky, you're craving, and you go, okay, I'll have the cookie and I'll have the coffee.
Yeah.
And then you have the dinner before dinner. You know what I mean?
Right.
By the dinner before dinner.
Yes.
And then the wheels fall off the cart and you go, okay, I'll try again tomorrow.
Yeah.
So from 3 o'clock on, that's where I think, okay, put a dot on your hand or start food journaling and let's be a little bit more mindful, because that's when I'm going to lose you. I'm not losing you at breakfast.
Make it really easy for yourself and just walk around with that bowl of carrots.
Yeah.
So that when you hit 3 o'clock, you start just, or 4 o'clock, you start eating them automatically, and that hopefully will fill you up and stop prevent you from going for the
100%
with the behavior, what have you.
Absolutely.
Okay, true or false, if you want to lose weight, I must give up bread and pasta. Got to get rid of it.
False.
False.
You do not
have to get rid of it.
You do not have to get rid of it. As you get older, your tolerance to sugars and grains gets a little bit lower.
Okay.
So you cannot have 10 grains a day and lose weight.
Yeah.
And that's where the paleo conversation comes in, because a lot of people are asking me, should I go paleo, Joey?
Mm-hmm.
So if you go paleo, you are removing beans, dairy, grains, crackers, all of this stuff.
Okay.
In my opinion, there's some good about paleo. It's not sustainable for people. It's not realistic for people.
Mm-hmm.
And it's not that long-term shift that I'd like people to make. So if you're going to have some grain, let's have some sprouted grain bread, which is phenomenal. Let's have some quinoa. Let's have some all bran.
Yeah.
So you can have, and then high-quality dairy is fantastic. So you don't have to eliminate all grain to lose weight. False.
Yeah, it's nice to have a tiny bit of, like, really good cheese. You don't need a ton of it because the flavor is so good, right?
Size of my thumb. Average lipstick. That's how much cheese.
That's how much cheese you get. Okay, true or false, if you want to lose weight, you must cut calories drastically.
You got to watch this one, because if you cut too low, your body's going to go into starvation adaptation mode, which means you won't lose. I have so many clients who come to see me, they go, I have the worst metabolism, I'm not losing.
Mm-hmm.
And I look at what they're eating, I say, no, you don't. You're not eating enough fat and you're not eating enough calories.
What does the fat do?
The fat keeps you in hormonal balance. So the fat almost, for lack of a better explanation, the fat makes your metabolism trust you. So it goes, oh, I have enough fat. She's not starving. She's not in a prehistoric time here. She can lose weight. So I can't tell you how much fat you can eat, 30% of your calories, and still lose weight. And it's great for your skin.
Got it. Okay, the next one. True or false, it is impossible to lose weight after you have hit menopause.
False, false, false. You can absolutely lose weight when you've postmenopausal, perimenopausal.
Yeah.
You just have to be on your game a little bit more. That's the truth.
Do you have to be, like, fairly strict with yourself if you're postmenopausal?
You have to eat in hormonal balance. You have to be a little bit stricter.
Uh-huh.
It's your grains and your sugars. And sometimes you need a little bit of help with whether it's a supplement or a green tea to boost your metabolism again.
Okay, so get that extra help and really try and be on point.
Absolutely.
When you get to that age. Okay, thank you. Really good answers.